If you find yourself using pivot tables and changing the default layout of the pivot table, possibly grand totals, subtotals, repeating items, putting in blank rows, then you need to take a look at changing your default pivot table settings. I'm Chris Menard. I'm going to walk you through that right now. Let's dive in. So here's my data. I'm going to create a pivot table. So I'm using the default pivot table settings in Excel. I want to see the brand, I want to see the rep, and I want to see the invoice price, and then I want to see dealerships, and let's have the dealerships run up and down. So over to the far right are my pivot table field layout. This video is not, by the way, on how to create pivot tables. I'm assuming you already know how to do this. If not, check out my other videos on getting started with pivot tables. Just to change this a little bit, I'm going to increase the zoom. So here is the default layout. Row 5 and 9 have subtotals for those two car brands, and the subtotals are showing up at the top. Also, I have grand totals over in column G. Those are grand totals for the rows going across. And down in row 45, I have grand totals for the columns. So, different options I could change if I wanted to keep manually doing this. And this isn't the layout that I like. Let's say that whenever I make a pivot table, I come to design and I put the subtotals at the bottom. And for the grand totals, let's just say I want the rows only. I want a blank row in between my rows. Look at row 9 and 11. There's a blank row there, on and on. And then I want to change the report layout. One item I don't care about for this compact form, which is the default layout you have, is my car dealerships, ABC Bill Owens, is sitting here in column A with the car brand. So I can go to report layout and make it tabular form. Now my dealerships are another column. So let's say I'm always doing this with my pivot tables every time I make a pivot table. No reason to do that. Two different ways to change it. Method number one, I've already got this pivot table looking exactly the way that I want to. I'm going to go to File, and I'm going to go down to Options, select Data on the left, and the very top box says Make Changes to the Default Layout of Pivot Tables. I'm going to click Edit Default Layout. Now, since I've already made all my changes, I can actually click on the word Import here. Before I click import, though, here are the defaults right here. Compact, grand totals on for both, subtotals are at the top, blank line unchecked. I've also got this repeat all items. I didn't repeat Acura, didn't repeat BMW, but I could have. And then I even have my pivot table options. This one drives me crazy, this AutoFit column width. So let me go ahead and I'll come back to that one. Let's just see if this works. I'm inside my pivot table. It looks exactly the way I want to. I'm going to hit import. Notice that all my items changed in here. If you notice that. So, and then from here, I'm going to hit blank table. I don't want to auto fit the columns. Every time I refresh, my columns auto fit. I don't like this feature. I'm going to turn it off. Click OK. Everything looks good. Click OK. And click OK. Now, let's just test it real quick to make sure it worked. I'm just going to go to a completely different worksheet. Similar data, though. Doesn't matter if it's similar data or not. I'm going to do brand, dealership. The reps were over here. And the invoice was right here. Zoom in a little bit. Remember, I turned off the auto fit. So now it's not doing that. That's okay. There you go. Real quick test. If I, for some reason, want column F to be really wide, when I right-click and refresh, it doesn't auto-fit. That's that feature I turned off that I don't care for. But this is working correctly. Method one was me created the pivot table and then went from there. Method two, by the way, oh, I got the blank row in there. Method two, I'm going to go back to File, Options, Data, same steps. I'm going to hit reset. In case you're wondering, how do I reset this back? Hit reset, hit OK, hit OK. So the other method would be before you even make the pivot table, just come to your options and change it here before you even make the pivot table to begin with, so you're not using the import feature on this one. This is a huge time saver if you're constantly making pivot tables and rearranging them to get them to look a certain way. I appreciate your time. Have a wonderful day, and my online training is available. Thank you.